Neruma Leti, General Secretary, Dennis George, National Office Bearers, members of the National Executive Committee of Producer, Provincial Executive Committee members, leaders of other federations here present, General Secretary of COSATU, Zwelin Zimavavi, Honorable Minister of Labour, leaders of political parties here present, General Siyabulisa. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, dear delegates, I wish to thank you for inviting me to your fourth Producer National Congress. As a trade union federation representing a significant component of the working people of our country, FEDUSA plays an important part in the evolving South African nation. Therefore, whatever policies you adopt will have a considerable bearing on the future direction we take as a country as we continue to rebuild South Africa into a non-racial, non-sexist, democratic and prosperous society. Your theme for this conference says social justice through decent work. And I want to believe that this Congress is essentially driven by the need to advance the interests of South African workers, motivated by the realization that all the workers of our country deserve better and decent working conditions and therefore a better life. Related to this is the important realization that all the economically active citizens of our country deserve to be employed so that they can be able to define their own future. This Congress is also taking place in a different global economic context, full of challenges which should be analyzed to help us come up with sound resolutions. As we all know, the eruption of the present international credit crunch was occasioned by, among other causes, the subprime mortgage crisis and the speculative activities of some of the international investors. Among other negative effects, this has resulted in the slow economic growth in many countries, including the shrinking of many economies in the developed North. Unavoidably, the current financial crisis enveloping the global economy impacts on workers all over the world, including our own workers here in South Africa. As a trade union federation, you know that one of the most dreadful consequences on the working people emanating from this downward slide in world economic output is the gloomy prospect of layoffs and job cutbacks. This prospect has the real threat of inflicting severe damage to our economy, as this would undermine our efforts to create employment and, by extension, impact on our war against poverty. Indeed, there is a need to surface this bleak outlook, since there is no knowing whether the ongoing efforts by the developed nations to seek a coordinated response to this unfolding economic crisis will prevent the global economic slide into recession or indeed depression. Therefore, in times like this, we would, as trade unions, government and business, do well to be on guard, to anticipate whatever negative repercussion stemming from this crisis on our own economy, and to think of better ways to address the negative effects. Dear delegates, given this background, part of the responsibility of the trade union movement is to seek creative ways to protect workers from the negative impact on employment levels. Fortunately, the South African banking system has escaped the credit crunch, and this is the reason we have not as yet felt the full impact of this worldwide disaster. This, to our credit, can be ascribed to the policies and regulations government put in place so that our people do not fall victim. As a result of our challenges are largely confined to the economy, which as part of the global system of trade has already shown vulnerability to the current financial issues. As I said, most of the developed countries, and indeed developing countries represented by the G20 group of nations, will be looking for solutions at a world summit to be convened on the 15th of this month in Washington. This will be done so as to generate a coordinated response to rescue the world economy from further deterioration. In preparation for this summit, African ministers of finance will meet in Tunis, Tunisia, on the 11th and 13th of November to focus their energies on identifying effective means to minimize the impact of this crisis on the already struggling people of Africa. Equally concerned about the interests of the workers in different countries, the international labor movement has not lost sight of these developments. It follows that our trade union federations in South Africa should, of necessity, join forces to optimally coordinate an effective response to prevent our workers from further sinking into the mire of debt and or losing their jobs. One of the lessons for us is to nurture a culture of saving amongst our people. But of course, you've got to earn decent wages to be able to have something to save. Normally with ordinary workers, there's only one day that they hate intensely, and that is pay day, because they then remember that even as they receive, they are paying with one hand, it goes out through the other, because they've got to settle all kinds of responsibilities and obligations. And in fact, in the more desperate lower ranks of working people, by Wednesday, they are weekly paid. By Wednesday, they depend on the pensioners for taxi fares to be able to report for work. Such consumption by this category, including small and medium business, is one of the factors driving growth.